Hello, namaste, welcome to Greet Tarot. So how are you? I hope you're doing good. I hope you're having an amazing day today. So if you're new here, if you like my content, please support my channel, or if you have already supported me, thank you so very much. So in the description box, I have my Instagram page link. If you want to follow me there, go ahead and give it a follow. And the decks that I'll be using in this reading will also be listed in the description box. Okay. So today's topic is messages from Lord Shiva. So that's the topic for today. Remember, these are general readings. So take what resonates and leave the rest behind, guys. And these are timeless readings also. So whenever you watch this reading, might have a message for you. Okay. So I have three groups for you guys. So choose intuitively, so relax, connect with yourself, let go of all the tension, all the worries, take few deep breaths and then select a pile or a candle that calls to you intuitively, okay? So for group number one, we have the orange candle. For group number two, purple. And for group number three, it's green. So close your eyes, relax, let go of all the worries, and then choose a candle or a pile that calls to you intuitively. Okay, so the timestamps will be given in the description box. I'm gonna start with group number one. Group number one, if you have chosen this orange candle, let's see what is your message from Lord Shiva. Okay, so I'll just keep this here. So you have chosen the card number 20, Star of Venus. Okay, so I'm getting like wear red color. Okay, red color is very good for you guys. Okay, if you have red color dresses or shirts, anything, just wear. Okay, it will be very good for you. When you wear that red color dress, it will give you a lot of happiness. You will feel very energetic. I don't know, for some of you, red color is good for you guys. That's what I'm getting. Okay, or maybe eat red color foods, maybe red apple or something like that, or strawberries, something. Okay, so red color. Or maybe it's related to your root chakra also. I'm getting like balancing of root chakra. That is what you need to do. You need to focus on your root chakra. And with the Star of Venus, so for many of you, I feel like that you have certain talents, you have certain creative talents, and you want to move ahead with that talents. But at the same time, there is a fear, right? There are fear whether this talent will provide you the finances or not. So here Lord Shiva is telling you to just put that effort, like just work on your skills, produce the things you can do, right? Produce the paintings or whatever you produce, just produce it without stressing too much. Just work on it with love, with happiness, and just believe in the universe, just trust in the universe, and things will flow for you guys. So the only thing that will stop you is your own fear. Sometimes we feel like that our creative talents or our abilities will not give us the success we want, right? And because of it, we stop doing what we like to do and we do something else because of our fear, right? And so here Lord Shiva is telling that you do the work, rest, universe will take care of. You don't have to think about that, right? All what you need to do is, if you have a creative talent, if you are working on your creativity, if you want to start that new business, if you want to work on your career, whatever you want to do in your life, maybe for some of you, you are focusing too much on the financial fears right now, just focus on the things that you want to make. Just focus, like when you are happy, when you are joyful, and when you are doing that work, you will get the outcome that you desire. So the fear, that rather putting that negativity into your work, just put that positive optimism. That's what I feel Lord Shiva wants you to know right now. Okay, And star of Venus, I'm getting star quality. You have the star quality. So for some of you, you want to get recognized, noticed. That's also possible for your creative abilities. I feel like that. So financial healing is possible at this time. So don't worry about your finances. Don't worry about, maybe you're making money right now, but you're very, very focused on your future. Oh, if this talent will give me that benefit in the future, in long term, you're very stressed right now. So maybe you're thinking a lot about your finances. So don't stress about your finances right now. Just enjoy your work. Keep on putting the effort you're putting. Keep on doing the work you're doing. Rest, give it to the universe, okay? That's the message from Lord Shiva for you guys, the first message. And you're very creative people, I feel like that. You have this dark quality, you can produce a lot of things, like different ideas you have. Work on that idea. Maybe you are a content creator where you write scripts or something like that. You have this ability, okay? You get a lot of idea, creative ideas. So work on that ideas. It will give you the success. Don't let fear come in, okay? The only thing that will stop the movement, like the progress, is your own fear. If you're stuck into something, like sometimes that happens, right? We do the thing and then we doubt our work. Then we stress whether this will give me the desired result. Instead, just put that positivity into your work, okay? That's what I'm getting here. For some of you, I don't know why you are some of you are worried about your hair fall or something like that. So if you want to consult to a doctor, just go and do that instead of worrying. Or maybe just check your vitamins, if any, if you are low in vitamins or not. Okay, so let's see, what is your message from Lord Shiva? For group number one, what's the message from Lord Shiva for group number one? I just felt like shuffling today on camera. Let's see, what's the message? Oh God, all the cards are on the floor. Give me a second. I'm sorry for that. Okay. So let's see, I'll just shuffle once again. So what's the message for group number one Lord Shiva? I'm getting Lord Ganesh also for some of you. Maybe you believe him and he is with you, okay? Okay. Yeah, you don't have to do everything by yourself. You don't have to, like, for some of you, I feel like you care a lot about other people. Sometimes you overcare. Sometimes you know, if your friend is calling, you will leave your work there and go and help your friend, even though if it's a small matter, right? Sometimes you sacrifice a lot. Maybe now it's time to do things for yourself, to focus on your work. Yeah, let them handle, right? Maybe you're enabling someone, you're helping too much, and because of it, the lessons they have to learn, they are not learning. You are helping them. You know, it's their life. They have to learn the lessons by themselves. You cannot help everyone every time. So I'm getting like that energy where you are saving other people. You're helping other people. Maybe finances wise also, there is someone around you who asks for money again and again and again, and you give it again and again and again. Don't do that. Don't do that. Say no for that. Okay? Because I feel that person, you are helping because you're kind, you want to help that person. Maybe they are your children, or maybe they are your siblings, or maybe they are your parents you are helping. But there should be a limit, there should be a boundary. If they are misusing it, you need to stop doing it, right? Maybe because of it, your finances are not increasing, you're having that financial fear because you're helping a lot of people. Helping is good, always good. But are you over helping? Are you sacrificing your desires for others? Like maybe you are planning, you're saving money for something, and this person comes and takes the money away from you. So it's not a happy thing, right? So say no. So I'm getting that energy. You need to say no. And I feel like with this hello from heaven, it's some of your ancestors or your passed on loved one is saying that to you. Just do that. Okay? Don't enable. Like enabling, you know, it's it's bad. I feel like when we enable people, when we always help them, they feel like that it's our duty to help them again and again. Don't do that, okay? It's difficult. Yeah, saying no is difficult, but sometimes you need to do it. It's good. You know, what you're doing is sometimes is not good for the other person also. They will do that again and again if you don't stop it. Okay, so let's see. It's time to take action. Yeah, it's time to take action towards your goals, desires. So maybe you're saving for something. You want to start something. And then this person comes and you have to give the money. So you're not getting that money. That's why you have a lot of financial fears. You're helping people a lot. Maybe this person should do things for themselves. You can help. Helping is good, but sometimes it's too much. You need to set that boundary. Okay. Yeah. Divine director intervention and purpose. Divine intervention is occurring. Know that you are being guided. Happiness is your purpose. Yeah. So it's like everything is happening for you at the correct time. Okay, so don't worry, have patience right now. It's very difficult to have that patience. I know, understand that, because you have been waiting for so long. But remember, you have to learn certain lessons. Maybe you are helping this person again and again. Maybe you need to take stand for yourself. That's what you need to do right now. Like, this is my work. I was working hard for this. That's why I got this money. You should also work hard, so you will get that money. Look, I can help you. I love you. I help you. But I cannot sabotage myself. I cannot sabotage my dreams and desires for you, right? So maybe you need to learn that, right? And I feel like for some of you, if it's possible, you can consult someone who is good in finances. You can consult someone who you can trust, like who knows how to invest money, what to do with that money. Okay, so that's also I'm getting. For some of you, you're spending too much, like you don't know where to invest your money. So maybe I feel like there is someone who will help you with that. So or seek someone who is good at it. Okay. And remember, you are here to be happy. You're not here to always think about your finances, always worry about your finances, right? You're here to make money. You're here to enjoy that money. You are here to buy the things that you want. You are here to do that, right? So remember that. And there is a lot of awareness. I feel for many of you, you know that this is not good. This is not good for that person also, and it's not good for you also. You know that. You understand it, you have that awareness. But then too, because your heart is very kind, you love this person, you keep on doing it. You feel like, how can I say no to this person, right? Or maybe they try to manipulate you. They tell you that you have to help. They make you feel like that. No. They have to work for themselves. You know, healing also, I feel like, we cannot heal anyone. They have to do that, right? We can only just guide people. We cannot heal anyone, or we cannot do their work. They have to do that, right? So yeah. Let's see what else. If you're feeling stuck, I feel like that. This is just because spirit wants you to know something. Maybe something is round and round happening in your life, and you need to break that cycle, that pattern. It can be something that is related to yourself. Maybe you have this behavior that is not good. Maybe you need to end that. And when you end that, things will move forward for you. Or maybe you help people who are taking advantage of you. So yeah, that's something I'm getting. You're giving too much. You need to set a boundary. Group number one. Yeah, see from a higher perspective. Yeah, you know, your parents have taught you to help other people, be kind to other people. Sometimes we are kind to other people, but we are not kind enough to ourselves, because no one teaches us that, right? No one teaches us, really, in our society. I feel like no one teaches us to be kind to ourselves, to speak nicely to ourselves. Like, we are taught that self-care is not good. We shouldn't be doing things for ourselves, right? We should give it to other people more and more and more. And maybe that's what you're doing. You're giving, giving, giving. You're not getting anything back. So maybe you need to change that perspective of yourself. Like, take a step back. Look from a different view. What are you doing? Is this good for you? Or maybe this habit is good for you. Like, is this person taking advantage? Is this person not working and taking my money? What is happening, right? So you need to change your perspective. It's just an example, okay? Maybe it can be a different scenario for others, right? But whatever it is, you need to take stand for yourself. And when you take stand for yourself, when you let go of the people who are taking advantage, it's not that you don't love them anymore. It's not like that. It's best for them also, right? When you say no, they have to work for themselves. You cannot provide every time for everyone, right? So that's the thing. So you need to change. You need to, like, eagle flies above. Their view is so big, right? So you need to change your perspective. Or maybe it's your limited beliefs that you have. Because of it, you're not seeing the whole picture. Sometimes we feel like we can make this much money only. I will have this much money only. Because our parents told that money doesn't grow on trees, right? So I have to work so hard to get little money. This is all our limited view about money. So you need to let go of that. For some of you, it's like your parents told you that being artist, you will not get the money, or being creative will not make the money. You have to be an engineer. You have to be a doctor. You have to be you have to be in this bank, you know. And I feel like you need and because of it, you feel like that you will not be able to make it. Let go of that. Universe has so much of abundance. Just align with universe. You will be able to make it. And do what your heart guides you to do. Okay, because all we want is happiness. We are not here for, we are here for happiness. We are here to learn lessons, but we are not here for stressing. We are not here to please other people, right? So let go of that people pleasing. You don't have to please anyone. Just please yourself. That's what I'm getting here. For some of you, it's like you need to spend some time with you. You're alone. I feel like that maybe you're spending too much time with other people and they're taking away your energy. So you need to recharge. You need to protect your energy, chant, meditation, do something, some activity by yourself. Maybe you're always surrounded by people, so you need some that little alone time. Take that. You deserve it. Okay, so let's see what else. I just got the message that you have been getting this dream. Like, you know this. You need to stop something, but you're not stopping it. It's like you have been feeling it. You are very aware that this thing needs to be, this needs to be stopped. Like something that you have been feeling and like it, and you're not taking action. It's like, take action. Stop that. Or it's an habit of yours. Repeating pattern that you need to stop. Some of you are aware of it. So let's take one more card. What's that? Yeah, there's a lot. Just take one card. Okay. Baba is a true guru who takes on the suffering of his devotees. He will grant you relief and succor. So with this, what I feel like, trust and believe in yourself. Trust in the divine power. Trust in the universe. Pray. Give your desires to the universe, because you will be granted. Your wishes will be granted. That's what I'm getting here, really. And like, knock on that door. Like, keep on praying, keep on desiring, your wishes will come true. Don't stop believing, okay? If you have a desire, if you have a wish, if it's not coming true, don't lose hope. Just keep on praying, keep on working hard, okay? You will get that wish granted, okay? universe will grant you, Lord Shiva will grant you that wishes. Okay, so let's see the tarot. I'm hearing confidence is very important for you guys at this time. Be confident to say no. Yeah, if you've been presented with an opportunity, be confident to say yes. And if someone is taking advantage of you guys, say no. You know it. You're very aware of it. I feel like that. You know it. Intuitively, you know it. You shouldn't do this, but you do it anyways. Because you're feeling like, oh, if I don't do this, how this person will survive. You think too much. Let them do their work. You do your. Okay. Let's see what the tarot has to add to this. Two of Cups. It can be about your relationship also. Maybe you're giving too much in a relationship. You're giving your best. Maybe you're the one who is doing all the responsibilities. You need to share your responsibilities. That's what I'm getting here. Ask for support. Don't do everything. Or maybe you need to have an open communication with this person. Yeah, Justice and King of Pentacles. Yeah, I feel like for many of you, you need to have an open communication. Maybe you are keeping your desires, your dreams to yourself. Maybe for some of you, you want a kid, but I just got this message. You want a kid, but you're very stressed whether you will be able to provide this kid for this kid financially, and that's why you have this dream to become a mother or a father, but you're not communicating to your person because you feel like that they will not agree. So it's like, don't keep it to yourself. You will be able to manage it. Like, just say it out. Say your dreams. If you want to become a mother, if you want to become a father, just say. Have a communication, okay? That's very important. And when you communicate your desires with this Justice, things are going to balance for you guys, definitely. We have two here, right? And we have this King of Pentacles also. King of Pentacles is someone whose finances are very good, their family life is very good. So I feel like you're going towards that only. So if you are someone who have this desire to become a mother and you're just worried how your spouse will react, don't worry. Instead of that fear, just communicate openly. Whatever it is, you can come to a conclusion without, there will be differences. I'm not saying there will be not any differences, but you can arrive to a conclusion anyways, right? But I feel like with this Justice, whatever conclusion is it, like whatever decision you make, it will be beneficial for everyone involved. I'm getting like that energy. Okay. And I feel like if you have been working towards something, you will get the Justice. Maybe you're working towards your finances, you will get the Justice. You will get, maybe for some of you, someone has taken a lot of money from you guys. They haven't returned. I feel like if that is the case, you will receive the Justice there also. Okay. So knock on the door of the universe, keep on knocking, keep on desiring, keep on imagining your desires, and let go of that limited vision that you have about yourself, limited beliefs that you have, and think big, dream big, and you will be able to receive it. That's the message from Lord Shiva for you guys, okay? And we have the back of the duck, sun, right? The sun is going to shine. The clouds, the temporary problems that you have right now is going to be cleared. And sun brings a lot of clarity, a lot of peace. Look, if you're desiring to get pregnant, that can also happen. Like, but have this open communication. Communication is very important right now, okay? So that's it for group number one. Bye-bye. Group number two, if you have chosen this purple candle, let's see what is your message from Lord Shiva. And I'm getting yellow color for you guys. Maybe if you wear that, it will be very good for you guys. You will feel very good, bright, shiny, okay? I'm just getting that. energy for you guys. Okay, so actually you got two cards. You're the only pile who got two cards. So we have Padma Sundari, out of the darkness the light is born, right? And we have second chances bring success. So yeah, so here Lord Shiva is saying sometimes because of our past failures, we don't feel like that we can do this thing again. Maybe a project, maybe you started something. For example, you started a YouTube channel and it didn't work. So you want to do it again. Maybe you want to do something again. And because of your past failure, you are like, oh my God, in the past I failed completely, didn't work out. Will this work out again? Here, Spirit is saying, yes, it's going to work out. Okay. You know, sometimes we have to be in this dark to learn a lot of lessons. But because of, look, out of darkness, the light is born, right? Because when we are in this dark phase, that is when we become more strong, more courageous. And I feel like you have seen a lot of failures in the past, and that's, you have seen that dark period. Now it's time for success. I feel like you have developed your character, pile number two. You have become so strong, so courageous, and that's why I was picking up on yellow color is becoming more confident, believing in yourself, right? So believe that yes, second chances will bring success. So I feel like you're getting a second chance here for some of you. So like a job that didn't work out, and now again you're going for an interview for the same job. Believe in yourself. Be confident in yourself. Believe that everything will be okay. Yes, you have gone through that past failures. It's not going to repeat. Universe is with you. It was just to make you more strong. Yeah, sometimes we encounter failures. It's not because we are not worthy of it, or it's not because we don't have that talent or skills. It's only because sometimes we have to learn that lesson. Sometimes we have to go through those darkness, right? You know, even if you read a book, even if someone shares their experience, we will not know when we don't experience things. If we don't see that darkness, we will not know how that feels. So sometimes we have to feel it. Sometimes we have to experience it, right? It's like, I'm just sharing an example. It's like I have sisters. So when they got pregnant, when they gave birth, after that, I didn't know that motherhood is like, it's a lot of work, right? I didn't know because I didn't experience it myself. So when I became a mother, that time only I understood that how much effort we need to put in, how much work we have to do, right? It's a difficult job, right? So when I experienced it, I understood how much a woman goes through, right? So when we don't experience it, we don't know. So maybe sometimes we need to experience that darkness. Sometimes we need to experience that failures so we can grow as a person. Yeah, sometimes it's very uncomfortable. It's not so good. But we learn. We become more strong, right? And we are not afraid of the adversities. So it's like I feel like Lord Shiva is telling you, you had to experience those things because you need to become more strong. When the path is straight, we don't learn anything, right? Sometimes we need to learn. Sometimes we need to trust. That is how we start trusting, we start believing. Like you're moving forward with your in your spirituality, you're moving forward, you're spiritually progressing, okay? So don't judge yourself. Don't judge anyone, okay? So sometimes if someone is saying of their troubles, don't judge them. Because they are experiencing it, right? Everyone has different tolerance also. So maybe a small thing might affect someone in a big way. At that time, show that kindness, you know? Because I feel like it's necessary. We need to be more kind to people. Sometimes we don't show that kindness. We feel like, oh my God, I have gone through so much in my life. I'm not complaining. This is just a small thing. Why are you complaining? Let them complain because they don't know what to do. Just give them the guidance, right? Be kind. I just felt like saying that you are kind enough. Be more kind. Or I feel like if you feel like that people are not kind enough to you, I feel like that's happening. More kind people. You're attracting more kind people because you're becoming more kinder, more compassionate. Yeah. But definitely there is a second chance coming for you guys. You're the leaders. Definitely you're getting out of this dark period. It's not because you're not trusting, you're not doing good. It's not because you're not worthy. It's just because you have to experience certain things. That is life. You are here to learn certain lessons, right? And that's it. But there is a lot of happiness. There is a lot of light coming your way. And you know what? You can help other people who are going through the same things you went through. You can help, you can guide, isn't it? It was because of those experiences you can guide other people. If you don't have that experience, how you will guide? That's the thing, okay? Understand that. That's what Lord Shiva is saying. It's not because they don't love you. No. Nothing like that. So trust your spiritual path. Keep on moving forward. You're going to see a lot of light. And I'm getting Lakshmi Ma. And I feel like a lot of financial blessings also for some of you. You have seen a lot of, in your finances there had been problems. You're going to see the light, okay? So yeah, sometimes we need to experience darkness. It's not easy. I have, and I know that it's not easy. The process is not easy, but we will see the light. Definitely. Okay, that's the message here. Let's see what else for you guys. And we have number 8 also. So shine your light, guys. Be confident. The abundance is there. It's coming. I feel like you are already seeing. For some of you, I feel like you're already seeing the progress. The progress you're seeing right now, it's just a small progress. You're going to get a lot of progress in your life. That's also I'm getting for you guys. For some of you, you want to buy new jewelry or something like that. Just go for it. Bye. Maybe you're debating, I have a lot of jewelry right now. Should I buy? just buy. It's okay. I don't know. That's a very specific message. Oh, you got 2 cards. Imagination and knight. Yeah, you're very strong people with this knight. Like, yeah. You have the courage to fight. To fight the battles. You be patient, guys. Be patient. Everything you are imagining is coming true. You are warriors. You are the spiritual warriors. You are the leaders. You have the strength. Your purpose is big. So sometimes when a person's purpose is big, they have to go through the struggle. They have to see the darkness. And that's when they can shine their light from inside. And yeah, so believe in yourself. Keep on imagining your dreams, your desires, because you have the power. You have the power to get anything that you want in your life. So don't judge anyone. Don't judge yourself. Accept your failures, learn from your failures. It's okay. Don't be guilty about it. Don't have shame. I'm getting shame. You're very shameful of certain things that you failed. Maybe you didn't pass your driving test or something like that. You're very shameful. You're feeling shameful. Don't feel like that. It's okay. It's just a life. You have to go through certain failures and it's okay. Don't care about what others think. It's just your process. And when you will be ready, you will win. Okay. So keep on imagining what the things that you want to imagine. Just imagine. Just think big. You can achieve because you are the spiritual warrior. You have the quality. Like you can fight and you can win. Okay. Let's see. What is the message from Lord Shiva? Yeah, take time to reflect. So with this mirror, I'm getting this mirror. So look in the mirror, say some positive affirmations. You're worthy. You can achieve whatever you want to achieve in your life. So maybe for some of you, you judge yourself a lot. Like in the past, I was not able to do that. Why I did that mistake? Oh my God, I was such a fool. No. It's okay to make mistakes. It's just a part of learning. Like it's just you're learning, you're maturing, you're changing as a person. People change. The only thing that is constant is change, right? You're changing, you're evolving, you're growing, you're maturing. So don't judge yourself. Just remember how strong you were. You overcome all that, right? Even though you made mistakes, you did overcome all that struggles. So just be proud of yourself. So yeah, don't judge yourself in a bad way. Just like, yeah, I did that mistake, but I'm here now, right? Like that. That's what I'm getting. So take your time to reflect. I feel like your emotions, your intuition is very strong. So just take time for that also, like meditate, ground your energy. I even feel like with this mirror, you know, you will be very good at scrying. Maybe for some of you, if you have this crystal ball, you can see images, you can see visions. So you're good at it also, I'm getting here. But definitely, what you feel, write it down, journal it. It will be very good for you guys through that dark period. If you are in this dark period, remember there is light. There is a second chance. So don't be fearful. Don't judge. Have patience. Because whatever you imagine, it will come true. So imagine that positivity. Like the things that you want in your life. Imagine that. Imagine big. You can achieve that. Okay? Stand your ground. Don't give up. So let's see. What is the message? Let's see. What else? Look at the color, blue. Voice. Like you are going to be the voice for so many people. Like it's like you will be helping a lot of people. Your voice will help a lot of people. Your experiences will help a lot of people. Right, with this also I'm getting this blue color, and it's like throat chakra. Your communication skills are going to improve, going to develop. Your voice will be heard. For some of you, it can be, it's like you have very good singing voice, it will be heard. Okay, if you failed one time, it's not necessary that you will fail again. No, you will not. Just believe in yourself. You will be able to get the success that you deserve. And so if you are planning for something, if you want to take action, like if you have been planning and not taking action, it's the time to take action. So you have been feeling something with this, take time to reflect card. You have been feeling like, yeah, I should do this. I should work on this idea, but you're not working. Oh, I did that in past and it failed, but why I'm feeling like I need to do it again? Just go for it. Okay, so don't judge because you failed in your past, right? Don't judge because of it. Like if someone, like a child who goes to a stage for singing for the first time, and then they are like worried because the first time they did it was not good, everyone laughed, so they have fear now. So it's like it's time to break that fear, come out of that fear, full energy, and do it again. You will pass this time. That's the thing. Don't be afraid to try it again. So let's see. Was a message from Lord Shiva. Protection. Wow, look, you are under Baba's protection. A lot of protection. Your family's protection. Your family is protected. You are protected through this dark time. If you're feeling like you are not in this dark, you're in this dark time. When the light will come, the light is coming. You're protected. Your family is protected. Your finances are protected. Everything is protected. But what I feel like, it's like for some of you, it's that you feel like it, that there is no light. It's like more of a feeling. You're not in this dark period. You will be coming out. You're coming out. It's just a fear that you have. For some of you, it's just a fear. Like, if I do this again, will I go back into that dark period? Like, for some of you, it's just a fear. So let go of that fear. Okay, that's what I'm getting. You're very protected. This secure energy, you're very protected. You're in this bubble where divine, your universe, the ascended masters, the archangels, all are protecting you, right? I'm getting Archangel Michael also for you guys. Maybe you believe in him. It's like he is also protecting you. So cut the cords from the past. Don't take that baggage. Be like a fool. The fool doesn't carry their past baggages. Otherwise, the bag will be very heavy and then you will be like your back will pain. So don't carry that past baggages. Let them go. Drop it somewhere. You don't need it anymore, right? So just feel free. Take that chance again, move forward with it. Take action. Because the second chance that you're getting, it will give you success. Okay, but just take time to reflect on the things. Just follow your heart, follow your intuition, follow your intuitive nudge, take a leap of faith because you're very protected. Okay. So let's use the tarot cards. What the tarot has to add to this. Let's see. What are the messages from Lord Shiva? Okay, you got three cards. Let's take them. Six of Cups. Yeah, some of you, you're worried about your past. Like, I did this thing in the past. Will I fail again? That's what your spirit guides, Lord Shiva is telling you to get out of that energy. Yeah, you failed in the past. It was just to make you stronger, but that doesn't mean that you will fail again. So don't stop believing in yourself. Don't let the fear come in between. Okay? Yeah, Page of Pentacles. It's time to learn again. It's time to work again. It's time to start new. It's time to it's time for a fresh start. Like spirit is giving you the map. They have the GPS. All you need to do is to follow the directions. It's like your intuitive nudges. Follow those intuitive nudges and walk, guys. For some of you, there is like learning also. You'll be learning something new. Just go for it. Look, Three of Pentacles. So something about your finances, something about your work, you failed. You're not going to fail again. Okay, you're going to see the light. Okay, don't worry. So maybe working with people, maybe you had a project and it didn't succeed. The presentation didn't succeed. That doesn't mean that you cannot do it again. So don't believe in fear. Believe in yourself. Fear will take things away from you, right? So don't let that fear creep in. Take time. Whenever you're feeling fearful, take time, recharge. Speak to yourself. Listen to your heart. Listen to your heart and pray. And imagine the things that you want to achieve in your life. Because you will be successful. That's what I'm getting. You will be successful. If it's an interview, you will be successful. If it's your work, if you want to do that business again, you will be successful. If you want to work with other people, you will be successful in it. So you have learned a lot from your past. You have learned the things that you shouldn't do, like the failures, like what you did was not good. Like sometimes we do things and it fails. So you know what you don't have to do, right? You know what you should do. So do it. Just believe in yourself and go for it. That's the message for you guys. Bye-bye. Take care. Number three, if you've chosen this green candle, let's see what is your message. So what I'm getting is like divine is definitely with you. Lord Shiva is definitely with you. He's telling you to be 100% authentic to yourself. Yeah, there are people around you who are not authentic, and because of it they are getting a lot of success. They are getting the promotion because they are using different ways to get that. But you're not here to do that. You are only here to be honest with yourself. So don't do something that is not good for you, guys. Sometimes we get something but it might take away our soul. So don't do something that you might regret. Even though you will get the success, but you will not be happy from inside. So don't do that. Be honest with yourself. It will pay off. You are here to live in honor. Maybe for some of you, there will be people around you who will be taking advantage of you, and you know it. So say no to them. You can say no. You have to be strict with that also. You cannot say yes to everything all the time. So say no. Okay, so be honest. Do something that makes your soul happy. Don't do something that doesn't make you happy. Even though it will give you success, you know, sometimes some things give us success, but it takes our soul away from us. Like, oh, I got the success, but at this cost, I shouldn't have done it. You know, don't regret later. So be honest with yourself, 100% authentic to yourself. Do something that makes you happy. So yeah, that's the message for you guys here. And we have number four also. It's all about stability, security, having something. So it's like in relationship also, be honest with yourself. If you're not happy, really it's time to say no. Don't try to fit in. That's what I'm getting. Don't try to fit in. If you're not feeling happy, share it. It can be as simple as like, if you don't want to go to a party or a celebration, say no. Yeah, sometimes it's okay to say no. Sometimes we cannot smile all the time, right? We are humans, so yeah, it's okay not to smile sometimes. I'm getting zen like that, you know. It's okay to not to smile. People will be telling you like, smile, why you're not smiling? Why are you moody? Yeah, sometimes it's okay to be moody. I'm getting like Lord Shiva is telling, take your time. Just take a break. Be honest with yourself. If you don't go, if you feel like your friends are not honest with you, if you feel like you need to let go of your friends, now's the time. Do it. And don't apologize for that. Sometimes some people are here to learn us, make us learn some lessons. We learn and then we move on, right? So don't hold that grudge, don't hold that resentment, don't hold anything. Just let it go. Yeah, you're very powerful people. You have the power, guys. Smile. You have the power. Look, gratitude. You know, sometimes we feel like that, oh God, this person and I started working together. Now look, they have succeeded so much because they were not authentic to themselves. They did some things and because of it, they grew so fast. You don't have to do it because you have the skills. You have the power. You can be authentic and make your dreams a reality. So be authentic to yourself and give that gratitude to the divine, because there is going to be a lot of things that you will be grateful for. You are going to be very grateful. That's what I'm getting. Lord Shiva is saying there is so much to be grateful for, you guys. You'll be so happy. That's what I'm getting. For some of you, if you feel like you don't have any friends, you don't have a person, you don't have a people who understand you, I feel like you are attracting that kind of relationship. So let go of the people who are not authentic. Let go of the people who you feel like they are just faking. Let go of the people who are you feel like you are you don't want to spend time with. If you feel like you have to spend time with these people because you want to make a name or something like that, don't do that. Don't do that. Be authentic to yourself. So you have the power. Stand up in your power. Say no when you want to say no. And say yes to things that you want to say yes to. Okay? So that's the thing. Maybe you're working in a company. There are people who do like corruptive things or something like that. You don't have to do that. You can make the money. You can make. You can grow. By being honest with yourself. So be honest. You have the power, and you're going to be grateful for all the things. You'll be like, yeah, thank God I didn't do that. Right? So you're going to be very grateful. So there is so much grateful. You know, you'll be very grateful for all the things. I feel like that. So if you're feeling like why things are not moving for me, why it's not happening for me, understand things are going to happen for you guys. Things are going to move forward for you guys. So you have the power, you can achieve whatever you want to achieve in your life. Just be authentic to yourself. That's what Lord Shiva is telling you. And let's look at the numbers here. We have 31-4, then we have 12-3, and then we have 14-5. Look, we have 3 and 4 and 5. So there is leveling up. So yeah, be proud of yourself. Yes, you didn't do something that is not authentic to you guys, and it's good. So be authentic to yourself. And for many of you, I feel like there is someone coming your way, like good relationships, soulmate relationship, good friendships. So yeah, let go of those people who are just faking, right? Wearing a mask, being someone else. You are not here to fake. Just remove that mask. You're here to remove the mask. Be 100%. Be you. That's what I'm getting here for you guys. And with this, like the horns, I'm getting like a lot of messages. Your crown chakra is open. So receive, believe in those messages. Trust those signs. Maybe you're seeing numbers. Maybe you're seeing 333, 444, 555. I'm getting like that. You have been seeing a lot of numbers. Believe in it. Yes, you're going to progress. There is leveling up. You have the power. You can make anything happen. Just be authentic to yourself. That's what Lord Shiva is telling you here. Okay? So let's see what else we need to take. Yeah, let's. And I feel like you're not here for relationship. You know, some people just for the sake of other people, they get into a relationship and they just fake. No, you're not here for faking. You're here for like authentic relationship. If this relationship is not working, you're like, no, I cannot be in this relationship. So let go of that. So just you are here for honest things. You're here for you're here to be with honest people. You're here to be honest with yourself. So that's the thing. So if you're in a relationship, you're going to be 100% honest, and this person should be honest with you. If there is no honesty, you're not going to be there. And it's okay, right? For you, honesty is very important, right? And it's your best quality, I feel like. So yeah, Lord Shiva is telling you, be honest. Do that what makes you happy. Don't lose your soul. And I feel like you are, yeah, heart awakening, awaken to acceptance and divine love, give and receive in balance. So I feel like you are going to, there is someone coming your way. Definitely, I feel like a soulmate, a friend, a relationship or a co-worker who will give you the exact love that you give it to other people. This person will be honest, loyal, and yeah, that's what I'm getting here for you guys. So open your heart. So for some of you, it's okay to meet new people. Maybe you are very afraid to meet new people. So open your heart to new people. Communicate with new people. It's okay, right? So that's what I'm getting. Because there are new people who wants you in your life. Maybe they're trying to communicate to you, but you're closing off. You're not opening up your heart. Maybe it's time to open it. Because you feel like there are no honest people in the world. Maybe you think like that. Or maybe you feel like that I'll never get an honest relationship. So let go of that. Let go of that. Because there are people who are going to be honest, who will give you the love you deserve. The love you give, they will give it back to you guys. So yeah, honesty, loyalty, that's what I'm getting. So open up, guys. And we have Archangel Michael. You're safe. Angels, stand close. Surrender your concerns and allow a miracle to occur. So yeah, definitely you need to surrender. Sometimes I feel like you are not opening up. Like you're not open. If you are single, you're like, you want a relationship. At the same time, you feel like there are no one who will be so honest. So I'm not just going out. I'm not going to date anyone. I'm not going to meet new people. So it's time to open up, right? And that's the time when you will meet new people. Or if you want a friend, open up. Don't get closed off. For some of you, I feel like you're very closed off. So surrender your concerns. Surrender your fear about that. Maybe you want friends. You want a relationship. At the same time, you're so worried. And you close off yourself. Like as I told you, if you don't want to go to a party, you can say no, but you always say no. For some of you, it's like you don't go out at all. So maybe you need to go out and meet new people. Okay? That's something I'm getting here. I'm getting like some of you have a very peaceful, calming voice. If people listen to your voice, they feel so relaxed. Like if you call someone, they're so happy to receive your call. Your voice is so healing. And trust your inner voice, guys. Trust your inner voice. Yeah, choose your path. It's time to choose your path. What you want to do, guys? Embrace the energy of peace, yeah, and sun, enjoy success and happiness. So yeah, that's the thing. You are going to be happy, you're going to be successful. So choose your direction. So for some of you, it's time to like to go out and meet new people. It's time to be flexible. It's time to choose a new path. For some of you, maybe this company you're working in, there are a lot of dishonest people. You don't feel like, maybe it's time to go for a different job, try, change your path. It's okay, right? And yeah, sometimes you embrace the energy of peace. You feel very stressed. You don't trust people because you feel the world is full of dishonest people. There are only a few honest people. So you're very worried into getting into relationship. Maybe in the past you have met a lot of dishonest people who have stabbed you in the back. So that's why you're not trusting, you're not opening up your heart. But there is someone who is there in your life, who's coming. So you need to be open to that also. So embrace the energy of peace. So do some meditations. I feel like your voice is very healing. So maybe sing to yourself. It will be like singing in the shower. Sing. It will make you calm. It will make you happy. Your voice will make you happy. I'm getting like that. So maybe just record your voice, chant, and listen to that. It will make you happy. Well, that's a very different kind of message, but I'm feeling like your own voice will make you happy, will give you that peace. Or maybe listen to chanting meditation, or meditation music. It will give you a lot of peace. So embrace that. And we have enjoy success and happiness, right? So you know what, you are going to enjoy your success and happiness because you were honest with yourself. So it's like, even though if you feel like that I need to change my path, change it, because that will give you success. So don't stress. So if you are in a job, in a place where the co-workers are not good, maybe if you want to change to a different, like in the company also there will be different departments, right? You can change to a different department. Do that if you feel like it, okay? Because it will give you a lot of success and happiness here. So yeah, if you're feeling that shift, if you want to make that shift, go for it. Open your heart, don't be closed off. Maybe for some of you are very closed off. It's like, try new things. Try new things. And these new things will give you happiness and success. Shine, be confident. Open up, don't be closed off. Like a little bit of closing off I'm getting here for you guys. Be open to new opportunities. Be open to change. For some of you are resisting change. So be open to that also. Okay? That's what Lord Shiva wants you to know right now. Let's see. Just once, there were a lot of cards. Just shuffle. Yeah. Oh, wow. Hard work and solution. Yes, your hard work will definitely pay off. Don't worry about it. And if you are worried about certain things, you are going to receive that solution. As I told you, you're a little bit closed off right now. So meet new people. Maybe these new people will give you some solutions. So be open to that. Okay? Open your heart. So sometimes we feel like that everyone is like dishonest here. No one, I cannot speak to anyone. Maybe you're closing off yourself. So there is someone who wants to talk to you. So talk. Because I feel like when you talk to other people, you will receive the solution that you want. Okay, so if you have a problem, you're going to receive the solution. Divine is telling you. Lord Shiva is telling you. And yes, definitely your hard work is not going to go waste. Even if you change the path, what you have done in the past, your hard work is not going to go in the bin. No, you will reap the rewards. You will enjoy the success. Don't worry. Okay, nothing is wasted. Your time hasn't been wasted. You have learned a lot of things. Nothing is wasted. Okay, that's what I'm getting. So believe in yourself. Keep on working hard. Your time hasn't been wasted. You have learned a lot of things. Be honest with yourself. Be authentic to yourself. Okay, that's the thing. And let's just end the reading with these cards. So let's see what the tarot has to add to this. The messages from Lord Shiva. Yeah, Tower. Mm-hmm. So yeah, something needs to go. Okay, so if you have built something inauthentic, you know, if you were not honest with this thing, that has to go. It can be relationship. If people are not authentic, it will go, and that's okay. Let go of them, because this will not give you happiness. So whatever has been built on a foundation that is not authentic, it will go away. Okay, and you know what, it's better that it goes away. Relationships, friends, because they will not give you anything. They will not give you the happiness. So it's a good thing. Yeah, you're going to move forward. You're going to move forward. For some of you, there is like shift in direction. If there was a path that was not good for you guys, if you're working with people who are not good for you guys, maybe you're moving away from that, like quitting this job and moving away, moving far. It might be a little bit uncomfortable. It will be like a lot of changes are happening. So don't resist the change. That's the thing. Because this change will make you go to a place that will make you happy. With this chariot energy, I'm even getting like... this new place will where you will find a lot of good people. They will appreciate your work, your honesty, right? So that's what I'm getting here. So believe And it's okay to change direction sometimes. It's okay. One more card, Divine. We have Page of Swords. Yeah, for some of you, there is some sort of documentation work that needs to be done. So do it, okay? Don't, pending. Don't keep anything pending, like documentation. Yeah, that's something I'm getting here. Don't, if you have to sign certain documents, read it before signing. That's very important. Maybe for some of you, you are applying for visas or something like that. That's going to happen for you guys. So don't worry, your hard work is definitely going to pay off. So you know what, even if you're changing the path, you have learned a lot of lessons. So whatever work you have done in the past, it's not going to go waste. Okay, so believe in it. And the things that are not good for you, the things that are not, that will not make you happy is going to go away from you. So it's like a blessing in disguise, this tower moment for you guys. Okay, so that's it for group number 3. Bye bye.